Emmy-nominated actress Anna Maria Horsford joins us to talk about her legendary career.
Is A-Man the most classic show of all time, or is the theme song one of the best theme songs ever written? Which one would you give y'all?
I would say the answer is yes to both questions, okay? And I remember when I first met Vanessa, the lady who sings it, Armstrong, was so wonderful. And she said, do you know me? And I said, I don't know. And she starts singing the first. I said, well, everybody sings your song, darling. But I think it was the perfect marriage, the perfect marriage. In fact, I just went a little earlier this year to Philadelphia and stood in front of the church that they did the opening credits to. And that was wonderful. Yeah. So that was nice because everybody kept thinking it was, you know, because that's the illusion of TV. But I had never actually seen the building. And a friend of mine drove me in front of the building. He said, that's your church. And I went up and hugged the rocks.
D is like the person, the security guard for all of the places of the world. What was that experience to
be? Remember, before you were born, there was a long life before that. I love it. People think, oh, no, you just know I was there long before. And it was an interesting road to get there. It's almost like Dorothy in The Wizard of Oz, you know? There's so many steps you go, and God doesn't let you know. You know, when they tell you, you don't get any more than you can bear, you don't get all the good stuff either, because somebody couldn't say, well, one minute you'll be working with Lucille Ball and Christopher Reeves, and the next minute you're going to be with the Wayans brothers from 29th Street, okay? And every moment prepares you for the next step.
Because you have so many different roles that you've played.
Yes.
Does anybody ever actually say your name to you when they first come up?
No. And I answer to all. They say, D? I say, yes. Somebody, I was with a friend of mine, and somebody had called me by one of the characters' names, and I turned, and they said, they didn't say Anna. I said, listen, mind your business. You are with D now, okay? All right? And they asked me how the babies are and how this is. And people insist, whatever got to your heart, I'm willing to accept. So if I'm Dee, if I'm Thelma, if I'm Miss Jones, if I am Miss Ludlam, who I am this year on Be Positive, and who else? I forget some of the characters now. Let me tell you, I forget their names. I don't forget what I do, but I forget my names because I am everybody's mother. When Jennifer Lewis, a friend of mine, she said the mother of Black Hollywood. I said, well, I hope you carry some of my children because I have a whole bunch of them too now. I got Method and Redman and everybody else, you know. But it's, I think the wonderful thing about all of these parts is what we give to the world.
Most recently, you became a mayor. Would you ever be a mayor in real life?
I want to be now. I am the official mayor of Tuckahoe, okay? Wherever Tuckahoe exists, yes. And I love being the mayor. And I hope to go back for Easter, Thanksgiving, and every other holiday movie that we do, yes.
Would you ever date someone that you had to get a kidney from?
I would date somebody. I don't know about after they get my organ if I want to see them, but it's not a bad idea, you know? And I live so long, I don't know if I'll be able to donate. My father, he went to 100. And my mother only went to 90, so she was a little young. But Daddy, I said that I don't know if we could give away those organs because that's 100 years of living. He wasn't a drinker or a smoker. And I said, but I don't know if they're good. But the idea that you can extend your life that far, you know, I think it's amazing. So that's what Be Positive started out as. Now, the new season, because the guy got the organ, I'm working at an assisted living home.